Hello and welcome to another episode of me painting again. Oh yeah, we're painting again, and I've got this picture I actually took a photo of this morning when I was collecting my car, because unfortunately my car needed some work doing. And well, at least I got a good photo on the way. It's quite a rural area to walk down, and this little duck was following me, so I thought, oh, that'd make quite a nice painting. I haven't really done one where I'm almost in the water, so I stepped down a few steps and I was almost in it. And I took the photo and I was like, oh yes, that's just what I wanted to paint. So I'm excited about this one. It's going to be a fun one. I'm going to enjoy this. In fact, I enjoy most of them, but I'm going to enjoy this one especially because it's so fresh in my mind as well. So I just left that there. So if you wanted to take a still, maybe that angle's probably better. If you wanted to take a still of the picture, then you're welcome to, and then you can paint along if you want to. So I'm just wiping a couple of brushes. My brushes need some cleaning. Just giving them a quick wipe. So you can see the canvas is another one that I pre-painted on. on its side, one of these dodgy self-portraits that I've done in the past. You know, you've got to practice, haven't you? It's not a bad painting, but as it's an oldish one. Quite funny, actually. When I used to paint in the wet-on-wet style only, I used to also paint traditionally, secretly. And, well, not secretly, I just didn't use to video it back then. And then it was quite funny because I used to get so many messages from people saying, oh, you should paint traditionally. And I used to think, well, I secretly am. It's just you don't know. It's funny, isn't it? It's funny, the perception of that way of painting. It's a bit weird. I don't know why people are so snotty about stuff sometimes. It's weird. Humans are weird. Anyway, let's get back to painting. So what we have, you can see my really bad chalk sketch just about. So I start with that, and then what I can do then is just start blocking in a certain colour. So now what I'm thinking is, I'll move this back here so we can do a few colour mixes. So I'm thinking I want that colour, and I can block this bit in here. And then I could mix maybe that, block that in. Maybe this could be there as well, and there. Then we've got this nice green here, and then a darker shade of this is probably there. Then we've got this nice dark here. And then that whole piece would be blocked in nicely, and then we can just put in these little strokes of detail. Got to put in the little duck at some point. And then we've got this building behind. I'm going to paint that a bit darker than that, because that's blown out because of my photo. Because of the camera equipment I'm using, which was actually my phone. It's not good enough to get that in the right shade, it's just blown out a bit. So let's look at the palette of colours. I've got all sorts on here. There's some cadmium yellow, some yellow ochre, and there's also raw sienna there. I just wanted to see the difference. I don't use raw sienna that much. It's just a darker version of yellow ochre, really. Some cadmium red, some burnt sienna, which I've got left over from portrait painting that I was doing yesterday. So I've got some left. Same with the white, titanium white. Ultramarine blue, some Naples yellow, burnt umber. Got two greens, viridian green and sap green. We should be able to mix the colours from this. We've got plenty on here, haven't we? Loads of different colours on our palette. So, like I said, I want to get this. My brush is a bit green, though. I'm not using a different brush. Let's try this brush. Wipe on the old bit of paper. This one, it's a nice filbert. It'd be nice if brushes were self-cleaning. You never have to wipe them, they're always fine. That'd be great. So I've got some yellow ochre, some burnt sienna, let's get some of that. Raw sienna in there. Have a look at that. Some white. There we go. All that raw sienna. So I put the burnt sienna in because it's got an orange flavour to it. Look at that. Ooh, it's pretty close round here. Slightly lighter there, isn't it? I might just throw it on like that, actually. Quite like that warmth there. So I might throw that bit on, bit there, lighten it, do this bit here. All others move it. So what we got? Quite like this here. Paint on. And I'm just going to get a little bit of light. It looks a bit. We don't have to do it exact, do we? To there, I think like that. That straight and then that angled. Some dark bits to put in as well. This bit's sort of a burnt sienna-y colour here. It's all like that anyway. Not exactly like that, but it's sort of like that. We're doing this as if we're sort of there. We do it like we're there. We're painting, pretending we're right there, having a look. Go a little bit lighter for the actual rock. What's that eye doing there? Look at that tree there. there, haven't we? Something like that. I don't know. Something like that. Got that side of the rock there. And then it's grassy. Dark there. It's quite green there. Sort of like that. So that's, now I'm going to go for this, which is more of a browner.
And just put that brush there.
Give another brush a wipe. This really good idea in my head on making a brush rack so I don't line all my brushes up on my easel, but I haven't made it yet. It's in my head. It needs making. So I'm going to get some blue and brown. Sort of to the blue. Blue and brown to the blue. I'm gonna get this dark here, so I don't know if you see that. Just to show you this dark here. Look how dark that is. Now I've gone for the bluer side because it's cool, it's in the shade, so it's nice and dark. Together. Use flattish strokes. That's what I think about water. Bit of that mix as well. Bit of burnt sienna in with my brown mix. Just making that look a bit better. Thank you. move that in. The reason I want this to be like that, because I want it to show that there is a structure there that's man-made. And I need it to look... So that needs to be like that. It'll do anyway, it'll do. Throw same mixture. I'm just going to throw a little bit of white in it and a little bit of the sap green in it. I'm going to go along here. Just lock this in. Just blocking it in. Grab a little bit of that colour in there. Very dark there. Very dark in this bit here. Well, alright, we can put this on under there. Might add a bit of warmth to that bit of the red. Water here as well. It's got a green. It's a bit of a sap green. Throwing a bit of sap green in with that mixture and a bit of the yellow. That's not bad, it's not bad at all. A little bit of with this brown. Pull it straight down. Just sit back, have a look, see if it looks all right. I think we're getting something going. You can see this here needs straightening off. So many different colours. We've got to choose which we want to keep, which we like and we want to keep in. Yeah, it's taking shape. I think I'll get this green area in here. Use my dirt brush, grab some, you want quite a dark green, get some of the sap green, a bit of blue. We'll start with the dark. So if you look at this on the picture, quite dark there, and then we can decide about putting the blue in, or I'll probably put green, screw green in first, and then we'll put the sky in after. I think that's how I'm going to do it. I also noticed that this is very dark there. We can put that in. Really dark there, isn't it? Would have been nice to being able to sit there and paint, but I've got to be honest with you, it was so hot. And I needed to fetch my car, but still, I don't think I'd have been able to do it. So funny thing is, painting outside, there's things you don't realise. Other than people having a look at what you're painting while you're doing it, going, oh, what are you up to? I don't really mind, to be honest. But it can, if they're hanging around, it can get a bit annoying. Because you're like, yeah, go on, move on. You've seen enough, move on. Go about your day. Especially when you're in the zone and you really want to get painted, and then you get someone going, nice day, isn't it? You're like, oh god, blimey. It's quite funny actually, because I was painting in the middle of nowhere, literally in the middle of nowhere, and I was painting this old ruin, and this guy that I'd seen a few days before, while I was painting, again in the middle of nowhere, in this wood, and he was there. There he was. Everywhere I went to paint, thinking I was out the way of everybody, there's this bloke walking by. Oh, morning! couldn't believe it. Just throwing in a different green here. A bit lighter this bit, isn't it? Looks a mess when you first put in all your blocks. You block in all this different colours and it doesn't look like much, but this is the bit that is going to make your picture. The time you spend doing this is going to make everything better. Put in a few dark bits in there as well. Once we get rid of that face, horrible face of mine, sideways on, be happy when that's gone. I'm just going to mix it in another green, sort of a warmer green. I've just thrown it in the mixture that I was using for the water. Just threw a bit of green in there. Get this blocked in here. Could put a bit of that in the water as well. Actually. Not fully into the water. Down this bit, can't we? Stretches down to there. Anyway, we'll make changes as we go. Right, where can we paint now? We could do the building in the background and the sky. Maybe I'll do the sky next. So, simple sky, blue and white. There's this big blob of green here that I could do as well. Flip in between colours there. You can see that was a lot darker there. So I just chucked it in. Okay. Ultramarine blue and white. Really light blue. Nice, easy mixture. Close that a little bit up later, but for now. The caps there. Remember, always looking at those gaps where the sky is shining through. Your sky in here as well. To there and a few little blue bits. I'm going to start covering that. Just sitting back up. Spots in there. Really. Alright, that's starting to look pretty good. Starting. Get that roof in as well. Locking it in. Not too worried about it looking perfect. I quite like a painterly approach. Darker for this bit. Don't really see. see that well, so I think I'll do. I'm not going to try and paint that too accurately, really. Use this big brush. Bit of green there. And there on that door. You can see a little bit there as well. White and Naples yellow. I think I'm just gonna put a little bit of blue and go. Give it the indication of the something window. See, it's very easy to start doing too much, considering you don't really see that much there, would you? Right, let's move on. Just thinking about the rock work now, a bit of white and yellow, the old stone work of the building. Something like that. Oops. Anyway, the rest is quite well covered, so I don't want to do too much because it's just going to be covered anyway. Yeah, I think that'll do for that. Yeah. So easy to keep going and going. And really, all this is, a lot of it is background. Not only that, this is covered here with branches up there, which we can do. Just getting some dark colour. Try and painted it, and then we didn't really need it. A lot of it, anyway. Okay. A dark bit there. Just sitting back, having a look. Just looking at where I can put in. Glimmers of okay, just sit back, have a look. I've actually done that too big by the look of it. This should be more like this. always a tendency to paint, and I really need to leave that because it's less important because it's in the background. Okay, so I had a bit of a drink, had a sandwich, and I'm back. You've no idea, but I keep running away. So I'm just sitting back, having a look. I'm thinking about which bit I might do next. I'm thinking, looking at this bit here, might start putting some of that bit in. And then maybe this. And then we'll just work around. I'm keeping my brushes fairly big because I know if I go for a small brush, then that's it. This video is going to be hours and hours. So I need to avoid the small brush. I need to keep this loose, fresh, you know. I like saying that. Fresh. I might just put a little bit of this. I'm going to start this, it's sort of a yellowy, a tiny bit of red in it, I can see a tiny bit of red in it. Put a bit of Naples yellow in that, that's not bad. Need a touch of sap green in it, that's quite close. Got to remember that it's going to mix a little bit as well. So just load my brush with that. That's really close actually. So we'll put in a few of these bits, we'll just drag it. We kind of got to think as well. My stomach's going boing. Got to think about the lightest lights as well. What we definitely don't want to do is overdo anything. A little bit lighter for this bit here. Yeah. Just sit back, have a look at that. Ooh, that's quite light. There we go. Quite like that. I might put a bit of that in the water there. Because the water was moving, it kind of flattens it out a little bit, but you want to see a bit in there, why not? I'm going to get a bit of yellow ochre, a bit of this viridian green, kind of a brighter bit, just something different. Sort of a grass green that is now actually, and you can see grass there. Grass there. There. It's a bit of grass there. Just put that bit in. And a bit there. There's a little bit of light there.
Quite like that.
Always sitting back, always having a look. Got to always sit back and have a look. See what it's looking like as a whole painting. I'm quite liking that. There's a bush there. Get some darkish anyway. There's bush in there. Because the light was this way, and then a bit of the Naples yellow. And we can put a bit of that in the water as well, I think. And flatten it off a bit. See some oh, dear. Quite well. Yeah, that'll do. I want to get this Naples yellow. I've gone and used my dark brush to make light. No. I like to keep a light and a dark brush. It's annoying when that happens. I just wipe it off on a piece of paper. Go back to my light brush. So I've got the old Naples yellow, and there's a little bit of all sorts in this. I can start building this up here. Like I said, I'm trying not to go too bright too soon. Put a little bit there. Use my dark. Okay. I'll do. Change it a little bit, with that Naples yellow, we can add a little. Just add that feel in my head. Oh, have I started recording? I hate that thought. You'd be amazed at how many videos I've made when I haven't recorded. You get painting away, enjoying yourself, especially if you sneak off and have a cup of coffee or something, and then you come back, you sit down, you're painting away, and then you go, something's not right. Not quite sure what it is, but something's not quite right. And then it hits you. Doof. You haven't started the record. these leaves shapes. See how I break away from this bulk of colour. I always do that. I break away from it because then it keeps things looking a bit more airy. Use your brush in different ways. Don't feel like you always have to do it one angle, because sometimes the leaves are going this way, that way, and sometimes they're going backwards. You get all different ones. You can use lighter colour as well for some and light and darker for others. I'm using a hint of that Naples yellow just to bring out some of my leaves. Like here, I can see some really nice bright ones that need to come, really pop out in front of that dark there. Nice. And then we can go into like a bit of the old sap green to dull our colour. We can put some more in. Actually, we can go even darker than that. Put some really dark ones that go along here. So we're going to hide a lot of this, but you can't see all of it anyway in the painting, I mean in the photo. I wanted that background in, I quite liked it. See, I'm a braver painter than I used to be. I used to get scared of certain things. When I used to see something I'd not painted before, I'd tell myself, oh no, I'll miss that out, I don't want to paint that, because I've not done it before. But nowadays, if I see something I haven't painted before, I'll purposely take a picture of it and try and paint it, because these are the things that we want to get better at painting, because we haven't painted them. And it's a little bit of a chicken, really, to not try and paint stuff you've not painted. I mean, what's the point in painting the same old thing? See how I'm using a round brush to do lines like that? You'll be able to do that. Just a bit of practice, a bit of brush loading. You just load it so you get a point like that. You can see that. So you get like a chisel edge and then you can use it. Speaking of a chiseled edge, we can put this in while we're at it here. There's all sorts of marks in here. It's interesting, actually, how it all... under the water. I'll do with that, otherwise we're gonna start going crazy. Where is we up to? Just wiping my brush. I want to get some lights going on that. So my lights, like I said, yellow. Got this pile. It's got sap green in it. I can have some of this. Probably want it to be more green than that. Bit of that blue. I think that's closer to what we want for this tree. Yeah. We'll just have a look and pick out a few some areas it's lighter. So we want to keep some of the dark. We don't want to kill all the dark, like here. I'll keep that. Some of these here and there. Quite a few dark ones in here as well. Mainly because that's a bit too samey, I think. Just sit back, have a look at that. Oh, it'd be quite nice, wouldn't it, to get some of these branches. So I'll leave my brush both sides. And then I'll put a branch here. Some sideways ones. Like I said, you put them all over the place. Pick up a little bit more of the old Naples yellow. Do a few more lighter ones here and there. Sit back. I quite like that tree. I might leave it. Fancy having. We've got that dark there. We need that dark have put a few of those because you can see a few dots of light. Just using this brush. Just a warm that little bit there. I've got some really light bits there. We might as well put them in. Makes a. Gives the area a bit of difference, doesn't it? Quite like that. I really do like that, actually. Right, I'm going to get some of this green. I'll start going across here. There's sort of a, I can feel a slope there. Just going to pick up some yellow. It's not too bright actually, it's quite dull still. Put a few of these. Dark there. Just sitting back, having a look at that. I do like that. It's got a nice look to it. Now we've got this really bright one. Got a few bright trees so we can get back into our yellow. Some Naples yellow as a lightener. Instead of white, use Naples yellow to lighten it. More the yellow. Quite a lot of paint there actually. I'm gonna start. few of these in. Just kind of looking and get the feeling of a few. There's so much going on in there. I mean, it took forever if you was doing a paint every leaf. So this sort of gives you a way of painting in a few at once. See, impressionists tend to do a lot of dots in a similar way. I'm not saying the same, who knows how they thought. A few lighter ones here and there. While we've got that light on the brush. Breaks that up, doesn't it? Because it's very the same there. Do have a bit of darkening amongst that as well. Just throwing a bit of white into my yellow, get a real light colour. Yeah, I can put a few of them in there. Maybe I can put some branches in. I can't light branches. So we'll go into a bit of just gone into a bit of light. It's really just a light burnt sienna kind of colour. Just want a few branch light coming across here. Maybe a bit lighter. A bit warmer, maybe a bit of red in it. Few in. I'm not going to go too crazy with those, to be honest. Okay. Just splodged a big blob of paint on the door. Just wiped that off. So it's useful to have some baby wipes just in case things like that happen. And then you can use your baby wipe to get you out of trouble. Use it to wipe your hands as well. So I'm sitting back. I think what I'm going to do, you can almost see a bit of a reflection of a house underneath this tree here. Kind of a reddish brown. I want to create some of these shapes in the water as well. Just grab a bit of green. A green in there. You can see sort of a to keep that water flat, you gotta think flat thoughts. Nice to get this red in. Sort of a red with a burnt umber. It's a bit too bright. Yeah, this all works. You can sort of see that that's there, and just put that couple of leaves on top there. Yeah, that's quite good. Got some areas of water as well. I want to lighten up a bit. I'm just throwing colour in from all over the place. It wouldn't be very good for you to see that. I've gone into Naples yellow ochre, white, there's all sorts on there. It's what happens to me, really. Yeah, I start going all over the place for paint. As the palette gets more and more messy, you start getting colour from everywhere. I like this. So, oh yeah, I've got that duct put in. There's all kinds of different colours in the water. Of course, I don't want to go too crazy with you can see a few rocks. Rocks under there. Don't mind some of this kind of mixing. All these rocks and things. We kind of got to do it in a quick kind of fashion, in a sense that we don't want to over, overcook the painting. We don't want to bake it for too long. Nice when I start adding these blue bits in, actually. I could do with that. These bits under the water. Bit of a warm bit there. Put it in. Changes things a bit. There's a bit of a warm bit there as well. Okay, now this is what I've been looking forward to doing. Some blue and white, just the old sky colour. There's this blue here. Blue bits. Something here. Drops in here. It's interesting, isn't it, how you get these blue bits of light and water. Trying to flatten them off. I can kind of see a bit of a bit of the colour in here as well. And there's a wall there. Maybe I can get a bit of a dark sort of land. Really dark underneath that. that. Some hints of green in amongst this. I'll put in a few here as well. Okay, maybe there's a green in that. I think we should try and put that duck in with a few strokes, a few simple strokes, maybe like this. Try and keep it as simple as possible. And a little bit of yellow. Gonna have to mould that a bit. Oh dear. I mean, it's not bad. I was trying to do it without using a small brush. I don't need it to look too amazing. I do want it to look like a duck still. Get a bit of light. something as simple as that, I can get away with, I think. I just need to go really dark. Few of those. Oh, that's still done all right. Oh, that's not too bad. I might go with that. That's not too bad, actually. So, we can look at this as a unit a bit now. And consider, maybe I can just want a bit of that. Yeah, that wouldn't it? Something like that. I'm quite liking that. I might just break it up a bit there. And there. There's a bit of a wall. Other than that. Green. Just sitting back having a look to see if I need anything more. I'm quite liking it. I don't feel like I need too much more, to be honest. Maybe it's a bit of movement in amongst that. A bit of warmth in amongst this. thinking now it's probably a good time for me to finish. Otherwise, I might lose some of the... quite like that. I think I'm almost there, really. Keep thinking I can see something that I can improve on, but... I'm going to call it. Keep it the way it is, I think. There's a few little... Yeah, I think I'm going to call this. I really like it, actually. It really reminds me of walking down there and the little duck thinking he was going to come and get fed. Poor thing. And there I was with nothing. Fortunately. That's the life you take when you have a car, isn't it? You end up with nothing. Right, let's put a little JB on there. I'll have it down here, I think. So there we go, it's a nice, interesting painting to do. Hope you enjoyed it, hope you were inspired. Added that bit of red in there. I thought it needed it. Anyway, thanks very much for watching this episode. I hope you enjoyed it. I hope it got you inspired to want to paint something different, something interesting, and capture it on canvas. So thanks very much for watching, and I'll see you at another one. Cheers, bye.